Hi, welcome back. In today's video, we'll be covering Revelation chapter 4. And if you missed the first three chapters breakdown, don't worry. Find my End Times Prophecy playlist, and I'll link it here. We'll also be covering the names and meanings of some of the precious stones that are listed in the chapter. We'll be covering 24 elders and the four beasts and so much more. Stay tuned and let's get this thing going. This is a brief breakdown and Bible study of Revelation 4. Some topics of discussion include the four living creatures, who are also the four throne beasts, mentioned in King James Version, the 24 elders, and God's spiritual description. Here's a brief overview. John is called up to heaven by Jesus' voice. Then John starts seeing into the spiritual realm, specifically the throne room of heaven. The descriptions are heavily symbolic, and we are not to take them literally because they utilize similes and allusions and other stuff. A gospel message is revealed through precious stones, and the future redeemed church is also in this chapter and is not what you think it is from the start. Revelation 4, the throne room of heaven. In verse 1, we see that Jesus tells John to come up to heaven after Jesus opens the door. Are we surprised that Jesus is the first person that John meets? After all, he did say he is the way, the truth, and the life, and the only way to the Father is through him. He's a man of his word. John is now seen by the Holy Spirit, God sitting on a throne, in verse 2. In verse 3, John goes on to describe God in a symbolic manner. Like a jasper is a simile, according to Exodus 28 and Exodus 39. In those two chapters, we see detailed instructions from God to the priest on how to construct the priestly garments. Jasper is also referenced in Revelation 21, verse 11, in the form of a simile about the shining light of God's glory. Jasper is red and is also called the bloodstone. So I have three photos here. The left side, it looks like they dug it out of the ground, maybe washed it off a little bit. The middle one looks like it's the finished product, ready for sale. And the one on the right looks like it's in between. And with the light shining on it, it does look shining to me. In verse 3, it continues, a sardine stone, this saying is in the King James Version. Exodus 28 and 29 both mention Sardis as well in the priestly garments. Sardis is also a shade of red, like jasper. All of Jacob's sons had meaningful names that spell the gospel message. The 12 tribes of Israel on the right side have stones that correlate with their names. So with that being said, if the gospel message is in the 12 tribes of Israel, then in this chapter, what message is God saying to us? Here is the Sardis stones and three different photos. Let's look into the Hebrew meanings. Reuben means, in Hebrew, behold the sun. Look at Jesus. Benjamin means in Hebrew, son of the right hand. Jesus is the Son of God who sits at his right hand side. And that's the complete message. Sardis has a Hebrew word origin, Adam. It's very similar to Adam, which is the first man. And it's spelled A-D-A-M, which means to be red and ruddy, just like Adam. Jasper means to polish in Hebrew. So what do we do when we polish something? We make it shiny. Does it remind you of God's glory? In verse 3, I quote, rainbow round about the throne. In Genesis 9, we remember that the rainbow is a covenant sign that God won't flood the earth again. It has seven colors, not six. The rainbow that we see commonly displayed in our world with six colors is not of God. It's from the devil. We know that the devil loves to pervert anything that God has created. Seven is God's number of completion, so let's not forget that. And if you want to on your own time, you can research the seven colors for a message as well. Our God is an intentional God. Verse 3 says, in sight, like unto an emerald. In Exodus chapter 28 and 39 again, they both mention emerald. Emerald is associated with the tribe of Judah, which means praised or to be praised. Jesus is the lion of Judah. Judah is Jesus' tribe. Emerald also means to glisten and to shine in Hebrew. Does that sound familiar? Here are some images of what emerald looks like. Who are the 24 elders? Well, in verse 4, we see the 24 elders with gold crowns. White raiment is usually associated with pureness, righteousness, and heavenly clothing is associated with those two things. So it's safe to say we can say that these 24 elders are righteous and pure in God's eyes. The gold crowns represent honor, authority, and glory for heavenly and earthly kings, rulers, and leaders. The gold crowns and white robes for believers who endure until the end represent victory and reward. Feel free to read 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8. And they symbolize the redeemed bride, Church of Christ, of the future. They are only referenced in the book of Revelation. And if you find the 24 elders in other chapters, feel free to leave it in the comments. And please make sure to subscribe to the channel for more content. The first book of Chronicles, chapter 4, and the first book of Chronicles, chapter 5, both mention 24 sections of worshipers and ministers. So that's what helped me to come to the conclusion that the redeemed bride in the Church of Jesus Christ are the 24 elders. And this is my personal two cents. The 12 tribes of Israel times two witnesses equal the 24 elders, which are the church. And the witnesses can also be from the Old Testament and the New Testament as well. So this interpretation has different many meanings that we can discover. Let's go on to verses 6 through 9, where we meet the four throne beasts. It says, the four beasts are full of eyes before and behind. In Ezekiel chapter 1 and Ezekiel chapter 10, they both describe the beast in detail in addition to other angels. Those two chapters are very interesting because nowhere else in the Bible, up until the prophetic books, we see angels described in detail or the throne room of God. Their sole purpose is to praise, honor, and to give God glory 24/7 and for eternity. Verses 10 through 11, we see that the 24 elders cast their crowns before God and Jesus Christ. In Revelation chapter 3, verse 11, it says to don't let any man take their crown. That's where Jesus is talking to one of the righteous churches. And in James chapter 1, verse 12, it says that they will receive the crown of life. Those who endure until the end will take them off themselves and cast them in worship in heaven. The 24 elders passed the test of life and have graduated. They graduated the school of life, the tests that God has given them, the trials and tribulations that Jesus went through, they went through and triumphed. They overcame the world by the blood of the Lamb, which is Jesus Christ. Humans were created for God's good pleasure and to worship Him. When we listen to worldly music that do not glorify God, when we listen to worldly music that glorifies the world, ourselves, materialism, the devil, you know, etc., we are not doing the will of God. We are doing God a huge disservice. But our God has grace and mercy for us. So with this information, let's not have God reject us because we rejected the knowledge. Let's turn away from worshiping the world through music, and let's turn to worshiping God through music, because God is the original creator of music, and He gave humans and angels the ability to create music, but it's only for the glory of God through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. This is my favorite verse that I picked out because it talks about praise. And the tribe of Judah, the meaning of Judah means praise. And Jesus Christ comes from the tribe of Judah. So God is really placed the emphasis on praise in Revelation 4. Holy, holy, Lord God Almighty, who was and is and who is to come. The 24 elders are singing worship songs in Revelation chapter 4, verse 8. Let's take some time to worship God through Jesus Christ today. Not just today, every day. David, a man after God's own heart, was a man of worship. The whole book of Psalms was written by him and other worshipers. Let's start that back up, and thank you for listening. Did you like the video? Make sure to click the like, subscribe, and bell icon buttons and get notified as soon as I post a new video. Feel free to leave a comment, and please make sure that the comments are respectful and centered on topic. But remember, everyone, Jesus does tell us to not be deceived. Because 1 John 4 says, not every spirit is of God, but can be of Antichrist. So we should try or test the spirits. All right, everyone, that's it. I'll see you in the next video.